Hey, it's Sunday night, and this is another Surfing the Portal with Paul and Mindy. This is where we talk about the open source research that's happening on pineconeutopiaportal.wordpress.com. Mindy,
Oops, I do that
this is
every
where we
time.
talk about,
So sorry.
that's my shadow self, it always comes in. We have a lot of room in the chat tonight, so if you want to join us to explain what we're doing here, we've created an open resource investigation into techniques that might help targeted individuals, I call them selected individuals, mitigate the suffering, minimize the suffering, or otherwise, handle targeting. We're having a little dog issues out here. I don't really know what's going on. I think they're chasing a bird. But the idea for the portal was to have targeted individuals write down and send in techniques that have helped them survive, helped them get along, and helped them militate against the assault that's on their person daily. We've been going on for a couple months now. We have 24, I think, suggestions. You'll be able to see it when we start talking about the website. And these suggestions range from radio frequencies to praying to trying to focus on love to a myriad of other things, and you'll see it as we go through. Also, during this investigation, we had so much more information on other techniques that may or may not help from past experiences that Mindy and I have that we've created I think it's called techniques. And if you're a targeted individual, you can go into those techniques and you might pick something that nobody else has tried before because it seems to harmonize with you and it might really work against your targeting. So that's the whole idea. And that's what we're up to. And the reason we do these, hi Tony, and the reason we do these things on Sunday night is to keep interest in the portal alive and give you a chance to chat with me, things I know about what's going on in the portal, and chat with other people in the chat room. So that's what we're about. That's why we're doing these things. And we're going to cover a couple things tonight. One is we're going to talk a little bit about what's come into the portal, new techniques, and things that you might like to try, and things that we can share with you and talk a little bit about. And then we're going to have a new feature. Rather than Paul droning on about his theory about how we got here and what's going on, we're going to do a more practical thing. We're going to do a technique of the week. Now, the title Technique of the Week might be misleading because we're not going to do one every week. And it might not always be a technique. It might be a shielding thing. But we're going to start off with this technique. This is a technique that Mindy and I are going to get involved in too, because I think we're both feeling that this would really help us. So when we get to Technique of the Week, we'll talk about that a little bit. And I'll tell you what I plan on doing with it, and she's probably going to do much the same thing, and how that's going to work out. So why don't you start and tell us about what came in this week into the portal?
Okay, let me see if I can share our screen here. That will make it a little bit easier to talk about. Okay, great.
Are you seeing that,
Everything.
Tony? Tony Tiger?
Okay, I think I need to operate it this way.
Okay.
So we got some really exciting stuff in this week. I think five new things came into the research. I have looked at a few of them and found them just really delightful and useful. Starting with this one. I can't quite pronounce it. I think it's Hola, and this is a simple Qigong movement and sound healing exercise by Sincerity 9. He sent this to us, and I thought it was lovely. Paul and I have worked a lot with Qigong. We really, really like Qigong, and for quite some time we practiced it daily and used it
for healing.
Yeah, and it's very effective. It's amazing. This is a short video and it's quite lovely. I'm going to play just a little bit of it and hopefully you'll be able to see and hear it.
Connecting with energy of your entire body. Connecting with the energy of those beneath you. The energy of the infinity universe above you. You're going to move in your hand, slowly open your hand downward, connecting with the energy of Earth beneath you. Then lifting hands up, raising energy, arising in front of you, around you, connecting with the infinity. Then bring the energy inwardly inside of you, deeply into your body, deeply into your heart. Deeply into all your organ, glands, tissue, cells inside of you. Now we can move more playfully, moving your knees up and down. So lifting upward, gathering energy. Energy downward, feeling inside of you. Again, together, making the simple sound. Ha-la. Ha-la.
So that's just a little taste of one technique. Tony, were you able to hear the audio on that? Be nice to know.
Okay.
All right. So, this is a Qigong exercise taught by Ming Tong Gu. And apparently, ha-la means all's well and getting better. Nice sentiment. Oh, great. Thanks, Tony, for letting us know. Sounds good. So apparently this was sent in to us by, does it say who sent it here? Let me go back to.
But this is a research, which means that this technique is being used by a targeted individual now, and he or she thinks that it helps. It might be something to take seriously now. Many I do have pretty much experience with working with these subtle energies. Prana is kind of the same as the chi, and one's Indian, one's Hindu, and one's more Chinese. Western medicine denied the existence of the chi until 1960s because they couldn't measure it. But now it can be measured and it really exists now. When you use Qigong, what we used to do, let me give you a little simple exercise. If you rub your hands together, keep rubbing them, you know there's this friction moving in there. And that friction turns into energy if you just pull away from one another a little bit. So they're like an inch apart. And see if you can feel like a little ball in the palm of your hand. When you can feel that ball, you're feeling chi energy. And this energy, you can pull in from the earth, from the sky, and punch it out through the palms of your hands. The palms of your hands deliver this energy in a very gentle, loving, and caring way. If you're still holding your hands together like this, pull them apart so they're 3 inches away. And feel that ball of energy there? Well, there's ways to work with this energy. And what we used to do is we would start generating this energy and pull it in through the soles of our feet and the top of our heads and project it out through the palms of our hands. Concentrate on breathing. Breathe in, from your feet and from the top of your head, and breathe out the energy through your hands. If you're imaginative and you're creative and you're not all bound up in, I can't see anything, so there can't be anything there, then you're going to be a lot more successful at harnessing and using this energy. The first time I had a dose of this energy, Mindy and the practitioner who was teaching her how to do this got their energy flowing really, really well, and then held their hands against me, and in about 15 minutes, God, the most happy, pleasant, fulfilled state I ever was in. It's kind of like it gives your body the extra energy organs need to fully function. And
it took away your pain too.
Oh, it took away my pain too.
Yeah.
So, I'm not saying that you can jump up and start doing this and have amazing results. Qigong is a lifestyle. But I would say that since we know that it helps one TI, getting deeply into this may really help you. And actually, there are videos of people using this qi energy, push things away. There's a teacher in town here that I've spoken with about the use of qi energy. And he had a teacher, I think he was in China, teacher who was so good at this qi energy. There was a fight that was going to be staged in one room. He walked two rooms away from it and knocked the one guy down two rooms away with his qi energy.
It's amazing.
It's amazing. And
quite easy to work with and to learn how to work with. You can almost feel by moving your hand, if your palms are facing each other, by moving your hands in and out, you can start to feel the energy almost like it's a solid mass between
yeah.
your hands, and you can stretch it and have it have it grow. It's quite amazing.
Okay, well, that's that. I really compare it in the healing arena to stem cell treatments. Because what stem cells give you are a bunch of blank cells for your body to use however they see fit. It's usually to repair damage. This qi generates energy into your body so that it can use it to fix things that are in the body. So that's how it works in healing. And I don't know, just try it out. I think it's worth a shot, especially since it's been used by another TI and that selected person says it.
I would really like to hear back from you too after you try it. Anyone listening to this after the fact, or Tony, since you're listening right here in the chat room, try it out and leave a comment at the bottom of the post. And let us know how it's working for you, because that's what we're hoping, to gather information from people who try these things and then expand upon them. You know, recommend any videos you find that are good teaching videos. And
right.
We'll just keep sharing and building upon each one as they come in. Shall I move on to the next one?
Yeah.
Okay, we've got a classic meditation CD. This is the original recording and recommended by Brendan Hitt. Let's see if we can get over there. And this was a lovely little meditation. I listened to it. It's only 7 minutes. This was recorded in 2014. It's an abridging of a full-length enhanced exercise by Roy Masters. Roy has been teaching people how to overcome their problems with stress, fear, and pain since the 60s. He is America's longest-running radio host at 87 years old, still hosts his nightly show, Advice Line, 5 days a week. He originally referred to his technique as an observation exercise rather than a meditation. This is a guided meditation, an exercise which teaches the listener a simple and unique method that can have a profound impact on emotional problems and mental health issues like stress, anxiety, anger, rage, and addictions to smoking and alcohol. So here it is. Let's play just a couple of minutes of it. Take too long to load in.
I'm constantly fascinated at where this thing stops and where it starts. Now it starts, seems to, what's the pattern there? I mean, what it starts up, just start three quarters, it starts up.
Sit in a straight back chair and put your right hand by your side. Use the left hand to listen. And follow these instructions that are very simple without effort. No concentration is necessary. Just simply do what I ask you to do. Close your eyes. Look at your eyes. What do you see when you close your eyes and look at your eyelids? Surely there's little twinkles of light, different shapes moving across the screen of your mind. Is that so? Go to sleep. You're going to be fully aware. I just want you to look at your eyelids. Something magical happens when you observe those little pixels, whatever you want to call them, crossing the screen of your mind. It has all different colors, little sparkles from within. If you just do this and keep your mind just on those little twinkling lights and little colors moving across the screen of your mind, just be aware of them, and you will find that you are in a refuge, meaning you cannot see your thoughts. You could hear my voice, but you've left your thoughts behind. That's very important. This is what's happening. No effort is required for that. You have left behind. You are separate from your thinking. You are the thinker, not the thinking. You are in a refuge. Your thoughts cannot bother you here. That's why I call it a refuge. Something also magical is happening. Is it because your mind is no longer caught up in your thought? Consciousness becomes pure, not solid with the emotion-based thinking. And so it becomes like a lens. And that lens is the reason why light is shining through that lens of your consciousness onto the surface of your mind. And it's beginning to be a program to you. Please do not try to understand this. It's not uncoverable. It's impossible. But it's like magic when you see what's going to happen to you after this. Everything's going to change in a good way. Now, the next thing to do while you're looking at your eyelids and watching that little display is become aware of your right hand by your side. Become conscious of the first finger of your right hand. And
wow. I'm blown away with that. You know what I was expecting?
What?
I was expecting close your eyes and go back to a garden, and in the garden, walk forward and you'll see the clouds coming over you and relax and lay back into the green. You know those guided meditations?
Mm-hmm. Now this is lovely, isn't it?
Oh, this is great. This is heavyweight. Yeah, this will work.
It's a 7-minute meditation. And generally, like you, I'm not that keen on the guided meditations. They seem like a little hokey to me sometimes. And it seems kind of anti-meditation somehow. And yet, what does he call it? He calls it an observation exercise. Yeah.
So, meditation and contemplation used to mean the opposite things.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't think it was too long ago because there's a Brazilian song called meditation, mm-hmm. meditacion, and it's all about contemplation.
Right. is some confusion between the two, aren't there?
Yeah, and contemplation is just as powerful, I think, as meditation.
Right. Well, I remember...
So this is a contemplation exercise.
It is kind of, isn't it? But then again, you know, there are... I remember a teacher of a meditation workshop telling me that there are different kinds of meditation, for example, the positiva and the negativa.
Yeah.
Whereas the positiva, you're actually focusing your attention to a single point of focus, like maybe a rose. Whereas the negativa, you clear your mind empty.
Yeah. Well, see, that's, thanks, Tony. It is calming. It seemed interesting up to this point. I'm going to try it tomorrow and see if I can get into this. I'm a Capricorn, and so to me, anything, it has to be a little bit punishing, you know, that, I mean, you have to go through it and keep at it, you know. Mm-hmm. So that's why clearing your mind and sitting there fighting your thoughts, I think, in me, in those guided meditations through landscapes and over, just, this is a contemplation exercise.
Yeah.
It sounds really fascinating.
Yeah.
And is this is this in the technique area?
This is, let's see. Well, no, you get to this through the research, because this was sent to us. Who sent this to us? I can find it over here on the research page. I guess I...
What a find.
Yeah, well, isn't that wonderful?
My God, it's like worth doing this.
Yeah, Brendan Hitt sent that to us.
Thanks, Brendan.
Really nice. And I love the sound of the teacher's voice, too, wasn't it? That was mesmerizing.
He sounds like he knows what he's about. You know, it's like an Alan Watts or...
Right. Well, actually, it says he's been doing this. He's 87, and he's been doing it 5 days a week for quite a long time.
Yeah, I can't wait. I'm gonna try that this week.
His website, his name is Roy Masters. PTSD, very simple form of meditation.
So I think this might be the technique next week.
Yeah,
because
maybe.
I'm gonna try it. I'm certainly gonna try it.
Good. Right. Technique of the week, that's yet to be
revealed, if you're hanging there with us. We were gonna have a...
And let me see what Tony says. I'm relaxing today since it's been raining. Good. Relaxing, there's nothing like it. It's so important.
Right.
It's not esteemed as highly as it should be.
That's right. We can celebrate getting through September.
Hard time focusing. I know, I am too. So I think clearing the mind does help. I really do. All right, let's go to... Number 16, let's be in nature without electronics. Rose Knight sent this to us. And she actually made a video of what she does to cope. She outlines it in her video, which she calls Targeted Individuals, Let's Be in Nature Without Electronics.
More
NTI Basics. I don't really get, this is the hashtag, right? When they put the number sign there.
Uh-huh.
I'm not really exactly up on how those are used, because she uses them several times there. All right, let's see. She uses geometry and psionic energy healing and protection along with organite and shungite. And she's made this lovely look at for a few minutes here and gives tons of links to other things. So you can all follow up on those links and see where they lead you. Let's play a couple of minutes of Rose's video.
To start out with, for those unaware, here's a description of what a targeted individual is. Planet is surveilled regularly, and this is to catalog our habits from what we eat, who we talk to, if we get vaccines, what political statements we are making, etc. Targeted individuals are those of us who are aware of this control and speak out about it And as a result, we suffer because of it, especially when we communicate this info to others. We are regularly under attack by microwave radiation, electromagnetic weaponry, sleep deprivation, even sometimes forced telepathy and forced remote viewing, genetic experimentation, forced astral dream interference, and more. Where's my proof? First, learn about voice to skull and other mind control technology practices.
Right, I haven't listened to the entire thing yet, but it sounds like it could be quite interesting.
What's the idea?
I did listen to maybe half of it, and she talks about getting into nature and how that helps her.
Oh, that's right.
When she gets away from all the electricity,
right,
and the weaponry in her home, getting out into nature really relieves a lot of,
right,
a lot of problems. And I would wholeheartedly agree with that, because even though I'm not targeted, being out in nature, incredibly, when I am in
well, about
a stressed
a month ago,
out
you
state,
and Romola talked about it.
Yeah, that's true. So I think it's really important and worth listening to. So follow up on that one. And let us know what you think. Do leave comments. If you scroll down on these pages, it says here, leave a reply. And you can write as much in there as you like. I don't think there's much limit. So you could share your experiences that are related to this. And hopefully that will start a dialogue among a lot of people. And we can start sharing information. Okay. And let's go back and see what else we got this week. I think there was one more. No, there's two more. A few things that have helped me over the years by Patricia Jackson. And she writes us a nice letter here sharing her history, that she was a student of yoga in the LA area. And why don't you read a little bit of this, Paul?
When I began to resist and left them for good 5 years ago, the harassment really started. These people were only a small portion of a larger sex trafficking network here in LA. These people appear to be members inside of all kinds of organizations. They, I believe, are the Illuminati.
Yeah, and this had something to do with her involvement with yoga, which is really interesting, although she says, I can't recall what it was, but that yoga has really helped her. And then she goes on to give a few things that have helped her over the years. Staying away from caffeine, alcohol, medications when possible. She takes a natural anti-anxiety amino acid, theanine. I'm not sure I'm pronouncing that right. And talks about
keeping
fit
good,
with exercises.
Mm-hmm,
yeah. That I have noticed to be a theme among many of the selected people is their sleep is really disturbed and messed with.
Right. She talks about the Tao Te Ching too.
Yeah.
We've read that a couple times on a couple last portals, and I'd like to do it again, but I'm not going to. Something else. That's good. So thank
okay.
you, Patty.
Thank
Patricia.
You so much. And
keep in touch.
Yes. Okay, let's see. Last one that came in was a first-person exercise for defense against DEWs. Brian of the family Wilcox sent this in.
Brian's really helping us with this. He sends a lot of things in. He's very interested in keeping it going. So shout out to Brian of the Wilcox
family. Brian's doing great stuff. He has a channel, a YouTube channel, and on it he's got some recordings, and I believe what this is, and I haven't had the time, Brian, yet to do it, but this relates specifically to an audio video that he made. So this goes into deeper detail, and if you click here on this link, it takes you to his channel, and I'm not exactly sure which one. He's got several here, and he's teaching techniques that he uses that he's really having good success with.
Yeah.
So really recommend checking out all of his videos and then follow up with the dialogue that he's contributed to the portal, because it's been really, really very fascinating stuff. And Brian's really gotten deeply into finding techniques that work for him, because I believe this has been going on for quite some time.
Yeah.
And so we spent a lot of time to really help.
Right.
Yeah.
I like to mention that, we started talking about with another doctor this week, and I'll talk about that in a minute, but I think that when you are starting, when you first discover you're in the program, getting involved in a technique like one of these is really a good idea, because later on, when you're more and more under their influence, and less easy to practice. You know what I mean?
That's a good point. So if you get well grounded in them early on, even if perhaps you don't feel that you really need them because it's just a little bit of street theater and aggravation. And
no, that's when to do it.
That's when you really want to do it, because you'll be in a better state of mind, a better state of physical health, to be able to actually, you know, take the time and the energy to practices.
Right. And I would advise everybody. That's why we've been in several practices now through the years. But I really want to get serious about it now, because we're all in the program. And, you know, whether you're being targeted, whether you're being street theatered, or whether you're being, just heavily voice decay, you really need to get started, get into this, because, you know, if it alleviates your pain, if it helps you at all, it's worthwhile. And we're devised by people who, many of them, by people who were really into both sides of the veil. You know, they could look at one side or another, and they understood that there were benefits to be gained through these exercises way beyond pain and suffering of life. So I think it's a good practice. And now we're in a time when we're all under assault, and no matter what we're doing about it, we need to be in good physical health and be able to have ourselves under control, whether it's with breathing, whether it's with concentration, whether it's with, you know, focusing on Jesus or whatever seems to help you. You know, you need to get good at it. That's what I'm saying.
Mm-hmm. And actually, there is a blessing in disguise here that I'd like to point out. I think so many of the selected people that we have been in contact with have had their livelihoods interfered with and are not working, and are even sometimes afraid to leave home.
Yeah.
Because if they go out, you know, they have to encounter their perpetrators. So the blessing in disguise here is you actually have the time for these things.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Even though you're constantly disrupted and assaulted, and we understand that.
Right. Actually, we were talking about the fact that it might be really important to create a little safe space in your home.
Yeah, the shielding.
Where you're shielded.
Yeah.
From any kind of, if you're having any kind of energy weapon
right.
attacks on you, if you have a shielded place where you could do these practices, hopefully you could do them uninterrupted
right.
and not under attack.
And it's very worthwhile to take time to do this, because it's going to help you in the long run. I mean, I would prioritize it above some other things. And try to make it part of your life, because it'll become more and more important. So anyway, I want to lead up to the big technique of the week. We need a drum roll, but I want to talk about one thing first, then we'll do technique of the week, and then I want to just have a parting little shot across the bow here. I had an interesting week because myself and a medical doctor who works with targeted individuals had a talk, and it was an interesting talk. Well, we like each other, and we've talked before because we have a lot of common interests. And we talked about a particular individual TI in that case, and it was interesting to me. This man is a trained medical doctor, allopathic doctor, and he's gone way beyond allopathy into actually helping people, you know, into learning techniques like acupuncture, you know, talk therapy, and then he goes into Eastern too. The difference between Eastern psychology and Western psychology. Western psychology deals with making people that are sick better. Eastern psychology is working to make people that aren't sick better. In other words, their development. Eastern psychology is all about development. Western psychology is all about making you better so that you go back to normal society, be a normal bloke.
It's about repairing damage.
Right.
Not really improving health.
Right. He's kind of grounding in that. And I, of course, have a PhD in consciousness studies and Eastern thought. So we overlap on that. But he was a medical doctor and a counselor, and I was an executive coach. So when I look at someone like this, or when I work with them at home, I'm thinking of things like, listening's the ground of everything for him and I. But after listening, I have techniques like this that'll help them. But this doctor, he's got talk therapy, he's got Eastern, plus he's got medications that might help. It was interesting for me to see the different approaches to working with TIs. And I could see in the long run that work with TIs, which will be coming more and more people are going to be doing this. Working with TIs to actually get together and have things like this. That seemed to help.
Right. Which is part of the point of actually having the portal at all, because we can work together to gather information from, you know, firsthand experience. What's working, what doesn't work, what could be tweaked to make it work better. And that's going to be a goldmine of information for all of us to share. So we really encourage you to, you know, direct people to this site that don't know about it, and work with it, and tell us how it's going.
Right. If you're on Facebook, put it on Facebook. We've never really gotten into Facebook, but if you're on Facebook, every TI should know about this resource.
Right, exactly.
And we need to know about everything that's worked for the TIs. All the TIs need to know. It's an open source resource.
Right.
And that's...
And it's a really good strategy to counteract what's being done to you, because they work by isolating you. That's one of their main tools of isolation. And as you know, it's very hard to talk to family members, friends, and explain to them what's going on without them thinking that you're crazy. So it's a community that can really help each other, and it goes so directly against what they're trying to do, is to keep you isolated and alone and unable to figure out what to do about it.
Right. Okay, I think we're ready. If we had a drum roll, we'd be playing it now. I'm going to get a drum roll for next week.
Yeah, let's get one.
Okay, sorry. Drum roll for next week. So right now, I'm about...
Okay, oh yeah, let me pull that up
on the screen. The technique of the week is...
The technique of the week is... It's called Iriolas. I'm probably pronouncing it wrong. Let me go back and find it here in the
Well, it's Gaelic. Gaelic doesn't follow any rules.
Distribute it to the person who sent it to us. Let's see if it says here. Oh, it was offered anonymously. Well, Anonymous, thank you so much for sending this because Paul and I really liked it.
This is incredible. Today. This is exactly what I need to do. Oh, myself. I overreact to everything. And I think it's partially because I don't take the time to breathe and think and work. Mm-hmm. I always react and not respond, you know. So
right.
I'm hoping that working with this technique, and we started today and we're going to continue working with this technique until forever, I guess. I don't know.
Well, let's see. Well, we're going to give it a good week-long dedication, yeah. And then we're going to go talk from there, right? We'll talk about it again next week.
But I will tell you that all of these practices aren't a week-long techniques. Sometimes you have to practice these things for a year to really get the benefits.
Oh, absolutely. No, I just meant, you know, for each of us to get an idea, is this something we really want to work with?
Yeah, yeah.
Because, you know, if you visit the research page on the blog, you know, there's going to be a lot of techniques there, you know, to sample, and we're not suggesting that you do all of them. We're suggesting that you use it as a starting off point, search on it, find one that really resonates with you, that works for you, and then, like, really stick with it. Maybe add in a few others if it works to do that. But this Gaelic, Olas, means growth of knowledge, and it's for stress control, healing, rejuvenation, revival of an ancient breathing and meditation program. How much more of this would you like me to read, or shall we go? I really loved this. I loved the video. It's done by a woman named Laura Knight. Jazik, I might not be pronouncing her name correctly. She's done is 2.25 hours long, this video. I really recommend listening to it all the way through. It's a good instruction and understanding. And then what's really cool here is she has given you the exact times when she talks about particular things. So it's an introduction, the first part, and then she teaches the technique. And then part three, she just gives you an audio walkthrough while you really concentrate on doing the practice. Also, it was quite beautiful, really, that she put in it. She put in
a lot of lovely photographs
of nature scenes.
And you can tell she's breathing correctly because her voice is low and soothing.
Mm-hmm.
Did you know that, supposedly, might be a wives' tale, it might even actually be true, but we'll find out. The American Indians, when the white people first started coming over Europe, they called them the people that had forgotten how to breathe, which I think is interesting and possibly mm-hmm. telling.
Right,
because we do in our culture, we breathe in our chest because we're always excited and trying to accomplish and get ahead. And
mm-hmm. And we also breathe in reverse. In other words, our stomachs are supposed to expand when we inhale and then empty as we exhale.
Right.
Correct? But most people, myself included, before I a teacher years and years ago, I always breathe the opposite way, and I think a lot of people do. So, do you want to read the quote that she opened?
No, I want you to read the quote, and then I'll add some.
Okay, so
color commentary.
Yeah, let me just play 2 seconds of it, and then I'll pause it.
Make a special. Ways. These will help your body to begin the process of detoxification. Following that will be the super powerful meditation technique. I use it.
I'm just going to stop it there because I came in 41 minutes into it. She starts out with a really wonderful George Gurdjieff from a book written by Ospensby, who did a lot of explanations of Gurdjieff's work, In Search of the Miraculous. And we thought the quote was really powerful, so we wanted to read it to you. Exercises which lead to the aim of mastering the organism and subjecting its conscious and unconscious functions to the will begin with breathing exercises. In breathing, nothing can be mastered. At the same time, to master breathing is not so easy.
Great. So Gurdjieff is a teacher. He can be associated with really heavy, really enlightening philosophy, or he can be connected with elements that were today. He was a person that was really full of wisdom, and I think this is one really profound statement. You know, breathing is the only it's both sympathetic and asympathetic. It operates on its own. You don't have to think about it. But you can control it with your mind. In other words, I can sit here and stop breathing if I want to pass out. And just forget about my breathing and it'll do it itself. Well, if you can control your breathing, your breathing is one of the things that controls your mind. Breathing, when you're panting, your mind is stimulating the lungs to do panting, and the panting is reinforcing your mind's flight and fight and mode. Whereas if you drop your breathing down to your lower abdomen in a calm and metered way, it will have the same effect on your mind. Or if your mind calms down, it will slow your breathing down. So there's a relationship between your breath and your mind, and mind control with breath control. It'd be interesting for TIs to work with that, especially during Voice to Skull, to see if they can change the tenor of the interaction.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. We very well could.
Anyway, this is a great tape. She goes through things. I kept, when I was listening to this tape, I was thinking, at some point she's going to stop and say, and you can buy the rest of my tapes, $99. But she didn't. She taught everything that you need to know right in the lesson. Plus, so this is a find. I'm going to use this. I'm going to get into this. And I'm going to really start controlling my breathing so I can control my mental reactions.
Absolutely. I really enjoyed it. I mean, the first part, she explained in a really simple, easy to understand way. Actually, I'm going to read from this just because it's easier to understand than if I try to remember. The intro video part one was an overview of the scientific and philosophical theories behind the breath and the action of breathing and its importance for physical, emotional, and spiritual well-being. At the end of the introduction, you learn an ancient breathing technique that can bring about a calm and relaxed state of mind so quickly and easily that anyone can practice it. From airline pilots to waitresses, corporate executives to kindergarten, anywhere. Anyway, this is the magic key to instant stress reduction and control. Then she goes into the instructional video in part two, and she teaches warm-up exercises, additional breathing techniques, including bioenergetic breathing that when practiced regularly can bring about deep emotional, mental, and psychic healing. You also learn about three-stage breathing and the prayer of the soul. For years, these techniques were secrets of both yogis and depth therapists, two lines of professionals that are arguably the proponents of methods that have actually been demonstrated to work. You know, I was talking to Paul about this earlier. I actually just want to sidetrack for a second. Breathing techniques in the realm of the occult, the secret teachings, and even as long ago as 5 years ago, we were given a free introduction to an ancient breathing technique. And I was so surprised at how it's kept so close to the heart, and then teachers will charge big money to teach you techniques, which makes it doubly nice that she's given this really incredible instruction for free. Because for some reason it has been held really secret and very valuable and costly to only, you know, the initiated or people who sought it out. Anyway, she gives good instructional practice exercises and warm-up exercises in part two, and step-by-step learn the technique.
And she's kind of cross-referenced referenced below. Video. So if you only want to work on something that day, if you only want to hear the vagal nerve stimulation, you can go to 10:14. Mm-hmm. So
that'll be really helpful going back. I mean, I really recommend you watch it beginning to end the first time, and then go back and pick out the parts that you want to review.
Right.
Over the course of the next week. So Paul and I are going to work with this all week long. And then next week talk, you know, hopefully we can talk to people who've also tried it and we can discuss it. But yeah, it seems to really, really be good. I was so relaxed at the end of it. And she does a little short meditation at the final part of it. That, I mean, I found it really powerful even the first time going through it, learning it.
Yeah. So we've got that, and maybe the technique of the week will be following up on this, and also the contemplation meditation one that just blew me away. All right. Well, anyway, that's the technique of the week. It's the breathing technique that I can't pronounce.
Yeah, we really liked it. Real easy to learn, very immediately useful, like right on the spot. Yeah. It's actually almost like overwhelming the length of time she had you work on it. I was like,
well, that's because you're not used to working on it at all. You're not used to doing that. Reduces stress. And while we were sitting there, I was just thinking, yes, stress. You know, all the things that they're throwing at us to survive or throwing at us for some reason. The fluoride, the GMOs, the chemtrails, and all that stuff. They're also throwing stress to TIs. So if it can in any way reduce your stress, that's going to help you survive no matter what else they send at you. Anyway, I wanted to kind of end up today not going into my theory on what's going on and how we've got here, because I've decided we're going to write that down and put it in a video or something, in case anybody is interested in following my logic down through that. But I did want to mention that I think it would be worthwhile, this is my suggestion and my opinion, and you might hate it, my suggestion to try to think outside of duality world. And we talk every night at the end about duality world. It's us against them. It's good against evil. It's black against white. It's the nemesh against the mensch. I mean, it's so crazy. It's hard to imagine a world without it. So, but I think it's worthwhile to try to imagine a world without it. If everything wasn't labeled either good or bad. And there is a world outside of it if you just imagine it. a world that's just flow and harmony and unfolding. And then if you look back on the duality world, get some insights on what's actually happening here. And the more insights we can get and collect, the closer we are going to be to understanding what's happening to us and why they're doing this. If you accept the black and white answer that they're psychopaths and we're good people, that they're working for the devil and we're working for the positive angels, duality, and you can be there. And I sometimes go back there myself. But I think it's much more worthwhile to try to look at it from outside of that duality and see if both of these sides are part of the same problem and they're both actually working for the same end. So when we mention something like George Gurdjieff, I want you to realize that I'm not looking at him as being a black master or somebody who's associated with the Illuminati, that I don't even know whether he was or not. Or when we talk about yoga, or when we talk about meditation. Well, you know, if that were practiced by Trotsky at some point in her career, well, it's got to be bad. Well, maybe it's not just bad. Maybe it's a tool everyone can use to benefit them. I think there's a lot of growth to be done through trying to climb out of duality for just a minute. And I know it's even more tough for TIs because they're hurting you every day, and I understand. But I think we're going to learn a lot from outside the matrix. So that's what I have for tonight, episode 8 of Surfing the Portal. I hope you enjoyed surfing with us. Hey, that's a good idea. Why don't we have surfing music?
We'll start with And Tony gave us a drum roll, which was really great. Thank you, Tony, for the drum
Tony, love it. You sat through the whole thing.
You know, people haven't found the reason why there's so few of you in the chat room is because backup channel to use the Google Hangouts because we got restricted from doing it on our main channel. So here we are on our backup channel. You'll just have to find us here on Sunday nights if you want to come into the chat room.
David, I live on a flat plane, man. No doubt about it. We've lived on it for 3 years now, and there's no turning back. So there you go. I don't bring it up very often because of very close friends that I love and admire. Spin around on a ball. Still love them. Okay.
All right. Thanks. Thanks, guys, for joining us here in the chat room. And come back. Tell your friends. Come back and see us again next Sunday. And join us on Thursday for the Techno Crime Fighters Forum with the lovely ladies of the Joint Investigation Team. And you have to go to Romola D. Report's channel to find that one. So a little hard to find these obscure talks, but we hope you'll come back again.
And we're building community, and it's happening. And it's all turning out for the best, even though they're hitting harder. You know, you ever hear that outside enmity, inside enmity? That's what's happening to us. As they hit us harder, we're getting to love one another more.
Yeah.
It's really cool.
That's true. All right. Bye.
Bye-bye.
See you next time. Have a nice week.